Hello, everybody, and hope you've been having a great Thanksgiving weekend with your friends and family, and you have had the chance to catch up with our CourseCare 101. I guess this has been a good experience for some of you to see how your students are doing and to be able to respect them, because respect meaning to see their existence from their point of view. Many of you have reached out and asked what's next and where are we going, and as such I thought I owe you an explanation, so I have prepared a very short video that explains the core ideas behind CourseCare 101. But CourseCare 101 is one of 9 courses that have been designed for our professors to be in line with our strategic direction going forward to better serve our target audience and to be able to become the kind of university we're planning to become. So let me share with you this particular presentation I have prepared. So as I said, CourseCare 101, now we're coming to an end. In a week, by December 9th, you should all be finished and hopefully use what you have gained for a better, more standard approach to managing our courses next session. Now, most likely you already have heard that there have been certain changes within our organizational chart, and we have added 2 new well-defined entities here, namely our Quality Assurance Council. And we've enhanced and improved existing Academic Council or Faculty Senate. Now, our Quality Assurance Council is managed by me, but most of the work is on Ms. Rupali's back, and she's been doing a great job, which I am thankful to. And also, our Academic Council is headed by our dear friend, Dr. Broman, who has been great. He's been working very hard and bringing the voice of our faculty into our decision-making process, just to make sure that their and your voices are heard loud and clear. And I guarantee you will not find anyone better than Dr. Broman to present you. Now, with that said, just to make sure that we have check and balance in place, we've divided our activities into 2 complementary groups, one under our Chief Operation Officer and the other one under our Dean of Academic Affairs or Chief Academic Officer. And the way it's been managed is that, as I already have said, Ms. Rupali, our QC and Resource Director, has been looking into how quality assurance will become a way upon which we manage our academic activities. And my dear friend, Mr. Defini Marcello, who is our course and LMS director, will be helping to make sure that professors receive proper training. And we are trying to also enhance our LMS Muro to a level that you will be very satisfied with. Good news will be coming to you soon on how we will make our LMS look and feel much better and more efficient when it comes to providing you the sort of platform in which you can manage your courses better. Now, obviously, you already know that we have a project management office director, and that is where the whole re-engineering of our university is taking place. It's managed by Ms. Gorgian, who is a very well experienced individual in managing enterprise level projects, and she's overseeing this whole process. And then, as you have heard, we have defined a new center called Center for Teaching Excellence that we have the honor of having Professor McKee managing it, and which is, by the way, very much in line with what she is doing here. A DBA on. So Ms. Gorgian is doing a DBA on Education 4.0 and how to better organize and manage and design for-profit universities to serve students of the future. And Professor Mackey is looking into course delivery methods that is both efficient, effective, and also very much in line with the future of education 4.0. So this is what's been taking place, and CourseCare 101 is part of this eventual strategic direction, and whoever wants to be with us on this journey has to go through CC101. There is no but or if about it. Having a certification that shows you've passed CC101 is mandatory to be able to qualify to continue with us into the future. Now, the objectives of CC101, number one is to make sure that professors understand our standard approach to managing their courses. So this is what that whole idea of course layout standardization was about. That's why you have to take images to send it to us, just to make sure that you understand this is going to be real. Obviously, we're going to have a collapse down like Acardon thing, so it's not so crowded, because some people have complained that, oh, it is very crowded later on. You're going to see every week have a pin on it, in which when you touch it, it expands. Otherwise, you start with a contracted set of 8 weeks or 9 or 10 sections, 8 weeks initial section, which is introduction, and final section, which are all the material and resources for the course. And that's how we want to make sure that our professors are on the same page with us when it comes to delivering a quality and efficient education to our dear and loved students, whom we believe that we have to serve. That's why this vision of mine, that students don't fail, but we as the faculty organization as well as staff fail our students. So it is our job to make sure that students are educated and have a valued education here with us. So that's what this course instructional guide is about. That will be the basis of our agreement with you. You do have to follow this course instructional guide that you prepare, and this is going to be how you manage your course. Also, to make sure that we have a clear communication line between us and you, to know that what we mean when we say CMU's quality assurance methodology, this is going to be very much standard. It's going to continue, and that's the way we will manage our course delivery system. And to make sure that, again, change management is all about communication, and we want to make sure that we do communicate to you our standard about professors' performance. And by the way, starting January 1st, everyone's performance will be measured upon these standards that have been developed with your help, by the way. Now, the outcomes, obviously, as I have mentioned, is going to be that standard course layout, not just for this session that you've learned how to do it, but also for your next session. You do have to have something of this quality. And by the way, your checklist will be modified accordingly to make sure that you do provide us a very standard course layout guide that shows how you're going to do it, and the same will apply for your course instructional guide. You do need to have a plan, which we call it that course instructional guide, and as such, we're expecting you to be able to provide us that, and your checklist will be modified to make sure that we have that in mind. Now, don't forget, this is the last week. Please make sure you finish all your work with CourseCare 101 by the end of this upcoming week, meaning 9th of December. And if you have any questions or concerns, please either reach out to Marcelo or to Rupali. You'll find them more than helpful. And don't forget that when you attend your next Academic Council meeting that is going to be on December 14th, you will be rewarded and awarded your certificate that shows you've been with us in this strategic undertaking. In the next and immediate video that I will be recording, I will, again, for your sake, overview what I expect from everyone when it comes to those two artifacts, namely your course instructional guide as well as your PLO, CLO mapping. Hope to see you all in our upcoming Academic Council meeting, which you are the owner, and it is your place to voice your opinion and let us share what you think. Thank you so much for being part of this strategic initiative, and we look forward to seeing you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.